Hello and welcome back to another episode of the Digital Health and Wearables series. Today I have a very special episode for you, but before I go ahead, let me make sure you subscribe to the channel and also check all the previous content in healthcare. And today I'm here at Sony, Sweden. We have a very special episode for you. We are addressing wearables and remote monitoring in healthcare and health. And I'm here with Anders Strömberg, is the head of the health solution division at Sony, and Jessica Tennhammar is the senior product manager for mSafety at Sony. Anders and Jessica, how are you?
Very well. Thank you for having us.
Oh, brilliant. I'm really excited about the episode today. We're addressing a very exciting subject. Yeah. I'm sure you agree with me.
Definitely.
Yeah. Shall we go straight to the questions?
Yeah, please.
And the first question that I have for you is, what's the real value of wearables in healthcare?
Yeah, so I think that from a bigger picture, it's the freedom for the patient. I think the wearable technologies as we have it today, with all type of wearables, from everything from hearing aid to glasses to watches and whatever, will give provide a lot of freedom to the patient. So the patient can be much more away from the hospital and being treated when they need to be treated in a different way, and actually adding that kind of extra good feel about it, that they actually been taken care of outside of the hospital. On top of that, I think that the whole taking away a lot of the burden from the healthcare professionals will be quite important. They need to take care of more people in a higher pace with more care and everything. Mm-hmm. So that blend of freedom for the patient and less burden on the healthcare professionals will be very important for wearables to solve that problem.
But also the potential in getting proactive care. Mm. So today we collect more and more continuous data. It's not only when we see the health professionals when they take the measurements. It's collected all the days. Mm. And to be able to draw conclusions for proactive care based on that. And also for you and me as individuals, we can start to understand how our body and mind work together and in our everyday life, and how our conditions are affected by what we do and how we do it.
Fantastic.
Yeah. And yes, to add to it, I think that with that knowledge, adherence will improve quite a bit. Mm. I think patients will be more engaged in their condition, and the doctors will see much more people doing what they ask the patient to do, because you can control it unofficially or kind a bit subtle in the background. So I think adherence will be quite improved as well.
Good reminders.
Reminders and everything, yeah.
Well, it's excellent insights there about proactive care. Also, we've seen lately with the pandemic the importance of having data, but also of having this new way of engagement. And certainly wearables are very crucial in healthcare delivery of the future. Yeah. Thank you so much. Moving on to the second question. What are the trends, the main trends that you are seeing in the industry?
I would sum up the trends in three words, like demand, drivers, and trust. So when it comes to demand, it's very much about people get more and more used to having wearables, being monitoring themselves. We have like websites called Patients Like Me and things like, so people is very engaged in collecting data on them. And I think that will drive the acceptance for being monitored by wearables. On the drive side, I think people, the aging population, yes, that we can cure more and more conditions, we have less shortage of nursing staff, will be a drivers for doing this kind of wearable into it. And then if we measure so many facts about you or data about you, I trust will be very important. So making sure that that data is being treated and protected and used in a proper way will be super important.
I think we should emphasize the data privacy concern for many users. It's the individuals must feel safe that the data is handled with care and it's not misused. If you have a wearable on you 24/7, it collects quite a lot of data and also different kind of data sets, and that can tell a lot of you about you as a person. So the individuals using the wearables should be aware of what data is collected, how is it managed, who is having access to it, and so on. And another thing around trends that I would like to add is when we talk about these more specialized wearables, it's the ease of use. So from a wearable user, there is today or other technology that they are using, it's quite high effort in all the technology to get it working. It's updates of OSS, it's like security update questions, it's settings, it's everything. So when we started to design this platform and the wearable, we had the base that it should be as easy as possible for the users to manage it. So they don't need another device to get it started, connected, and transmit data. They don't need companion applications to pair with other surrounding devices. So that has been really important, the ease of use for the wearable user.
Good.
Fantastic.
And maybe to add, I think that the industry, if we look at trends, I think it will be divided up between consumer type of wearables like this and more dedicated wearables that is have applications and design that is more fulfilling what is needed for remote patient monitoring. So these type of specialized devices will be more and more common around healthcare and not leveraging like consumer-based electronics, which is probably adds more, it's more for your style rather than the purpose of the device.
And they can be more custom made for the purpose so that the wearable is used.
Very, very, very good point. Certainly the fitness lifestyle is very different than the medical applications in healthcare and life sciences.
Yeah.
You mentioned really important points there about the ethics, the privacy, the security, the patient safety. We could do a whole conversation on this.
Yeah, definitely.
But moving on to the next question, what are the main barriers and how can we overcome them?
I think end user simplicity is probably one of the biggest one, to make it as simple as possible for the end user to embrace it and really be engaged in using these wearables. I think that just to make a reference, do you remember the Walkman from Sony, of course? They made a music that you could have the music with you wherever you went and running and everything. I think it's the same with this. You need to take your remote patient monitoring with you wherever you are. And you shouldn't be thinking about that you are so being monitored. It's actually part of your everyday life and make that simple for that. The other thing, barrier would be the digital divide. We talk about this as you would say that the younger generation would probably not have a problem with that. But I actually don't think that is the case, because there will be plenty of people that have conditions, shaking hands, they have problem to understand things, and they're purely not interested in technology. They will need help on making use of wearable technology as such. And then the thirdly would be that we still do stovepipe solutions. As we have in healthcare, you have your cardiology, you have your diabetes, you have your different kind of conditions, and you have one doctor for each condition.
Yeah.
I think going forward, that needs to blend together as a solution, and I think wearable technology could help in that, but it's still one solution at a time.
Yeah, and mSafety is a wearable platform, and we have a quite unique way of managing the user data. We don't have the same approach as the consumer devices. Of course, we have built the system based on the best privacy and security standards, but on top of that, we have also put an end-to-end encryption of the data So it's encrypted from the device to the service provider that is authorized to see the data. So we in Sony, we cannot see or touch the data. We don't have the keys to decrypt the data. And it also makes, for the service provider, that not everyone at the service provider can see the data. Only those with the keys can decrypt the data. And to add, you talked about the ease of use for the wearable users, but it's also ease of use for the service providers.
Oh yeah.
It should not be too complicated for them to manage. So what we have been thinking about in our wearable and platform is that you shouldn't need any hands-on activities when you unbox the device. So for service providers, they can send it out to the users, they unbox it, it is automatically connected to the correct endpoint. All configuration, both if it's personal configuration or if it's for huge fleets, it's managed from the service provider's backend. So they don't need to do these hands-on activities.
Brilliant. That's really fantastic. So mSafety, you really have very special capabilities, but you really thought about everything into detail. And my last question is, what is your future vision as a leading innovator?
So our ambition is that we should have the best and most adaptable data collecting platform for both health and safety remote monitoring. And we want to provide that to service providers so they can really speed up the innovation around proactive care and proactive safety.
And yes, to add to that, if you think about becoming proactive in this, it's about collecting data about you as a person or what is going on around you and everything. So what we see in the future where we will invest in is to create a data sharing platform so we can join together all data and people can make great ideas and innovations around that data. Because it's important that we remember data is something we provide as individuals, and we want to give that to companies or that give you the right service. It's not for us as a company to keep it for our own. We really need to come up to this data sharing mindset that we can actually provide proactive care using that data coming in.
And we should also add sustainability.
Oh yeah.
So Sony strive for very high sustainability goals. Not only those obvious KPIs we have with what paper we use and the volume we have in the packaging and so on, but also like the innovations or our products can contribute to better sustainability.
Which is very important.
Yeah, it is.
So we want to help to save lives.
Fantastic. Yeah? You're certainly on a big mission. Thank you so much for sharing these magnificent insights with me. Any final thoughts?
Yeah, I have a bit. Maybe this is going directly to you on this one, because I think you've been in this industry for quite some while and I've been talking about a lot of people around this. What I see is that the wearable technology is still very much about like rich countries. We are talking about Europe, US, North America, where we advanced the technology quite a bit. But what we really should think about, how can we take this kind of technology and help countries in Africa, South America, Asia, and so on, and maybe also in the most rural area where you need remote patient monitoring the most, it's still very underserved. So I think we should, as an industry, should come up with solutions, innovations around serving that population rather than only for the rich and famous.
Thank you. Jessica, any final thoughts?
No, I totally agree with Anders. We need to try to save the whole world and not only the rich part of it. And we need to save the planet and work with a better sustainability.
That's brilliant. Actually, my vision is that the wearables can change the world. So this is a magnificent way to end. Yeah. I want to thank you so much for having me, but also for sharing this magnificent work that you are doing with us.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having us.
I'm going to wrap up now. So to our viewers and listeners, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, I'm going to post some links in here in the body. Make sure you check the magnificent work that Sony are doing at the moment with the mSafety platform. And I'll see you all next week.